Back in February, there was a truck that exploded, injuring multiple firefighters. I have an update on that incident, and I'm also going to talk about this word that's kept showing up in the comments, BLEVE. Overall, 9 firefighters were injured in this explosion, and I want to clear up some misconceptions. When you watch this video, you can see this object right here crossing in front of the screen. A lot of people think it's actually a firefighter. It's a miracle no firefighters were killed in this explosion. And when you slow down the footage, you'll actually see this object right here isn't a firefighter at all. It actually appears to be some piece of tire or some part of the truck that's leaving the vehicle. Now, there were firefighters that were thrown a great distance. They lost consciousness. One firefighter was severely injured and spent over 10 days in the hospital. I currently don't have the status on all these firefighters, but I assume that some of these firefighters have yet to return back to work. There has been a lawsuit filed by the firefighters against multiple different parties, and they're claiming negligence because when they arrived on scene, they did not realize this was a CNG vehicle. They started their operation as this was any other vehicle fire, and a diesel semi-truck doesn't explode. It's not something that we ever worry about. You have to realize the compressed natural gas powering the vehicle exploded. There was no trailer associated with this fire. The placards are going to be very limited. You're not going to have a traditional hazmat placard. It's going to be more like a sticker somewhere on the vehicle. And when that vehicle's on fire, that's not something you're going to easily see. Realistically, the driver should have come over and alerted the firefighters that this was a compressed natural gas vehicle. The driver of this vehicle was not injured in this fire or the explosion. The driver was actually away from the vehicle, and she did not notify firefighters or dispatch that this was a compressed natural gas vehicle. If they knew this was compressed natural gas, that would have changed up their operation significantly because they would have realized the hazard involved. And the hazard isn't a BLEVE, like most people are saying in the comments. While there was obviously an explosion hazard, it wasn't a BLEVE. And that's a little bit of a technicality. Let's start by defining what is a BLEVE.
Big loud explosion, very exciting.
It's actually a boiling liquid expanding vapor explosion. To better understand what a BLEVE is, let's look at this mass casualty incident that happened in Rochester, Michigan, not too long ago. It started with this propane cylinder from an outdoor heater. It caught on fire and somebody had moved it out of the way. And when they did, they ended up dropping it on its side. Of course, multiple people came outside to see what was going on and watch it. And all of a sudden, it exploded. This truly was a BLEVE. And to understand why it's a BLEVE, you have to look at the second letter in this acronym, the L, liquid. When you have a propane cylinder, it's actually compressed down to a liquid phase. It's no longer gas inside of that tank. That's different from compressed natural gas. Like the name states, compressed natural gas is still a gas when it's in its container. Part of the issue is you need a different strategy when working with LPG versus CNG. The reason is the liquid. This demonstration right here will show you what happens. If I've got this fire, I've got this thing half full of liquid, I can put heat into this thing for quite a long time. However, when I move up and I move to the area where there's no liquid, it burns a hole right through the can. That's because the liquid, as it's boiling, can absorb a significant amount of energy. As the liquid's absorbing energy and boiling, it's off-gassing, and it's allowing the safety vents to work properly. So working with a fire involving LPG, your goal as a firefighter is to cool the tank to make sure that tank does not fail, because when that tank fails, that's what is a BLEVE, boiling liquid expanding vapor explosion. On the other hand, CNG, it's a gas inside of that cylinder. As you heat that cylinder up, the pressure increases significantly, but the safety valve, that's activated by temperature. So now if I'm a crew spraying water on this tank, I potentially could cause that safety valve not to function properly because I'm cooling the tank, I'm cooling the safety valve. When dealing with a CNG fire, you want to cool the area, not the tank itself. You want to allow that tank to vent naturally to keep things safe, keep things from exploding. When those tanks fail, it's not a BLEVE because you don't have that boiling liquid aspect. It's absolutely an explosion. It's a catastrophic explosion. Either way, it could be a catastrophic failure. It could kill firefighters or civilians in the area. That's why it's so critical for fire crews to understand what they're working with when they get on scene. And it's not always that obvious. The last thing I'd like to address is the traffic in this incident. The fact that cars are just driving through this scene, they don't seem bothered by the fact that there's a semi-truck on fire. Well, if you're already a firefighter, you know the reason for this. People are impatient. Everything's about them, and the public's just going to do what the public does. In an incident like this, we're focused on fighting the fire. Yes, ideally, we want to stop traffic, protect the scene, and keep everybody out of our scene, but it's not always that easy, especially if we don't have the staffing to actually shut down the road. Circling back to the injured firefighters, I do know that all the firefighters that were injured were released from the hospital. I'm not sure, again, if they're back to work or not, but I wish them a speedy recovery, and hopefully they don't have any lifelong injuries due to this incident.